Hello friends, welcome to my channel Gardening Maniac. In this channel, I will be sharing details about plants, especially indoor plants and outdoor plants. In this video, I will be sharing details about my indoor plants that I have been nourishing in my room from last 1 year. I have divided this video in two parts because of the length. In first part, I will share details about few plants that I have been propagated in my room from last 1 year. In second video, it will be continuation of this video.
First in the variety is a snake plant. Snake plant are easily available plant and can be purchased from any nursery nearby you at very cheap rates, 30 to 40 rupees. It can be easily propagated from a leaf or a bud which produce once in a year. Talking about a snake plant, they are very beautiful, elegant. Wherever placed in your house, it can be a desk, near side tables or anywhere. I have kept it on my tea pan. Talking about this leaf, it has various variety of colors in its leaf, that are light green, dark green, white, so it's still quite beautiful. Talking about it, air purifying quality, it has been certified by NASA that it's one of the best air purifier plants that can be kept indoor. When we talk about its growing habit, then it requires a well-drained soil, a garden soil which does not allow too much of water to stand in it. And talking about watering quality, then it does not require very much watering. You can water it once in a week or once in a month during winters and once in a week during summer. But one thing I want to suggest is that I like single bud plants in snake plants. If you like multiple bud plants, then plant in a big container because it gives too much of buds. I have removed all the buds from this and kept propagated somewhere else so that it can be planted elsewhere. I will suggest that if you are a beginner and want to start planting with indoor plants, then snake plant is a very easiest option for you. Can be propagated very easily and you will love it when it will propagate and start growing. Talking about second plant is Monstella obliqua. It's a very easily grown plant, but don't go with these leaves because due to high rise temperature of about 45 degree in North India, it has dried out. But don't worry, new leaves have started coming and these are very beautiful because of its cut and color. About me, I have loved this plant because office one of this variety. Most of the people ask me, is it an artificial plant? Because I have made it a vertical plant by using these pens and everything so that it can be erected with less leaves. I love this plant. About its soil quality, well-drained soil, it like little bit of moisture but protect it from direct sunlight, because direct sunlight will make these leaves burn and plant can die as well. But remember one thing, never allow the soil to completely dry out because it will destroy its root. As a result, the plant can die. But if you are a plant lover, you should definitely keep this plant at your homes. Talking about third plant, that is a succulent that I love the most, is this one. This succulent is the most hardy succulent I have ever found. I have planted very succulent at my home, in my rooms, in the hall, everywhere. But most of them were not that good in developing, but this has worked very well. Because of its fleshy leaves and hardy structure, it does not require too much of water in it. Most of the time, I forgot to water it, and water in a month or 15 days. But talking about its support, it is growing very well, fleshy leaves, good color, good texture, but its growing is very slow. You can see only 2 to 3 leaves in 6 to 7 months. But it's its propagation time and you can see new buds are also coming over here. So I will be removing it and planting in new container. So then more of such plants can be developed and can be kept at various places in our home. But I love this plant, especially because of its texture, color, everything. And about soil, simple soil, not much scientific soil. The soil should not be clay. That's the only one thing you have to do. Well-drained soil. Talking about the fourth and the last plant Now today's series is Peace Lily. Last in our video is Peace Lily. Peace Lily is an indoor plant with basically required medium to light amount of sunlight. But its blooming also decreases with the amount of sunlight. We should protect it from direct sunlight. It's an indoor plant and everybody loves it because it's one of the only available plant that bloom inside the room, because most of the blooming plants are not organized according to your room or indoor conditions. It's a very, very rich plant. It does not require much fertilizer or over fertilization. You can fertilize this once in a 6 months or a year. But talking about watering, never overwater it. You can use the habit of irregular watering it. Just touch the soil. If it does not stick to your finger, simple rule, then you can water it, else don't water it. Its root might get rotten and plant make it die. One more quality about Peace Lily is that it's very beautiful with dark green leaves and white flower, but it's a good air purifier plant. So wherever you are keeping it, it will purify the air in your room. And so it will beautify your room as well as purifying it. So what could be a better thing than that? So this was the list of the plants that I have described in our first video. If you like our video, you can like, press the like button, share it and press the bell button for the further videos which we are going to share you in the coming future. You can follow us on Instagram as well as Facebook. Links have been given on the web. Thank you.